Creating looping animations within Vizrt Artist is quite simple, but there are a couple of pitfalls that you'll have to watch out for. So to begin, let's work with a position loop, and I'm just going to drag a sphere down. We'll throw a material on it so we can see it better. And I'm going to start my animation up here in the upper left, so I'm going to set a keyframe to start it there, move it to the right, then I'm going to move it down to the right and over to the left, and then back up to where we started. So I hit play, and our sphere animates around the render window. So I'm going to go into the stage button here, and you can see I have my keyframes and my animation. So if I click on my position here to the right, it opens up a loop window. So I'm going to click on the loop out button, and we have a number here that we can set a certain number of loops, or if we want to do it infinity, we can just click on the infinity button. Now notice when we click on the loop button how it creates these stroked lines and keyframes here. That's letting us know that it's now looping. So when I hit play again, it's going to go all the way around and it's going to reach the end. And since we have a smooth animation attached to this, it kind of slows up and slows down. And you may see a little jump when it reaches the end. So if it's too noticeable, what you can do is always come in here to your bounding box. We'll turn on the animation spline by right-clicking, and you can use this animation here to turn them on if they're not already. And you can line up your keyframes a little bit better this way. You also have the option, and when you click between your keyframes or the blue bar or on the position and your loop window is open, there's also a closed path button here that you can click on, and it closes the path. And it may add an extra keyframe, and if the extra keyframe is there, you can just delete the last one if need be and adjust the keyframes however you need it to be adjusted. So we click this, we see a little bit of jump. It's still a smooth animation, so we may need to set the first keyframe and the last keyframe to linear left and right, and now that will eliminate the smooth or the slowdown when it starts the animation and ends the animation. When you had the loop window active, there's also a swing out, so if you want it to reverse, you can click on the swing out as well, and now it's just going to reverse that animation. So we hit play, it's going to reach the end of this animation, and then when it reaches the end, it's just going to go back the other way. So that's the position. Now we can also do rotation. So let's drag a torus down here. I'm just going to copy this material on here, and we're going to hide the sphere for the moment. We're going to rotate this torus. So let's go into our rotation parameter here. We'll rewind our timeline. Again, I'm just going to start it at 0. I'm going to hit set key, and we'll rotate it once for 360. I'm going to hit set key again. So I'm going to go into the stage by clicking on my animation icon, and here it tells us our rotation, tells us it's a torus. The rotation parameter is attached to it. If I click on the rotation itself, it opens up the loop window. So I'm going to click on loop out. I'm just going to increase the number a couple of times. Again, you can see how it adds these extra stroked keyframes, and we hit play, and you can see how it starts and it stops a little bit. So again, this is a linear thing, so we can set our first and last keyframes to linear. So I'm going to highlight that last keyframe, set it to linear, and I'm going to highlight the first keyframe and click linear left and right. Now when I hit play again, it's still doing the same thing. That's because each rotation parameter, we have to take into account the rotation X, Y, and Z. So we have these 1, 2, and 3 buttons up here. Since we really only set the keyframes on the Y parameters, and we just set the rotation X to linear, that's why it's still slowing down. So I'm going to change this to 2, and I'm going to select my keyframe, set it to linear left and right, select my second keyframe, set it to linear left and right. You can see how it adjusted that spline there. And I'm going to do the same thing for the number 3 or the Z rotation. I'm going to select my last keyframe, make it linear left and right, and select my first keyframe and make it linear left and right. Now when I hit play, it's a continuous, smooth, looping rotation. Now we don't just need to work with primitives here as far as the looping, we can also do textures. So we're going to drag a rectangle down here, we'll hide the torus, and we're just going to widen out our rectangle here to a width of 500. And we're going to go back and grab some type of image, and we're going to drag an image and loop an image texture on here. So we'll use something simple like this picture of a clouds here. Now when it comes to looping images, you'll want to make sure that the first point and the last point are exactly matched up, or else the loop won't look right. So let's first just come into our image editor, and I'm just going to scale this up a little bit to fill the rectangle. Now when it comes to looping this particular texture, I'm going to start on the left edge here and match it up to the left of the rectangle, And that looks pretty close right around there. So we'll match that up. And I'm just going to set a keyframe there. And then I'm just going to move this on the X a little bit. And we'll go down to where it looks like it's on the hard edge again. And roughly right about there, we'll set a keyframe and we'll go into the stage. And now it tells us our texture position X. So I'm just going to spread this out a little bit and click in between the keyframes and it opens up our loop window. I'm going to click on the loop out button, adjust the numbers a couple of times, and I'm going to try this out. I'm going to hit play. And it's starting and stopping. So I'm going to change these keyframes to linear once more. And now I'm going to hit play again. And let's see if we have a constant motion. Now we have a constant motion here. And as it continuously loops, there is no hiccup or anything like that. If I came into this keyframe here and adjusted this value just a little bit and we hit play, once it reaches that end, you're going to notice a big hiccup because the first and the last keyframe or first and the last point of this image were not matched up. So if we go back and reset this keyframe to what it was, 27.2, we'll type in. And this should match it up again, so now that it's constantly looping. The thing about images is that once you have this loop point set and you come in, replace different images with other images, it may not always keep that same loop point and you may need to readjust, especially when you're talking about the mapping. If you change it to vertex or reflection, it may not always keep that same loop point, so it's something that you constantly have to readjust and work with.